Hello everybody, it's a me, a friendly porcupine, and I'm here to bring to you, upon request from the previous video, the Mega Constructs Halo Kisano Cyclops Ray, retailing for $19.99 and containing 232 pieces. Everybody, I completely forgot to talk about the box. Why am I talking about the box? Very simple, because Mega Constructs has done something super duper cool about the box. It's an annoying problem I've always had with Mega Constructs boxes. You know, when you try to open it up, you lift up this flap and you slide it underneath, and it always cuts your finger and it hurts a lot. Well, no longer, no more. Because basically they incorporate a little stitched part right there, pre-stitch. You just press this little thing, lift up, boom. Boxes open up, no problem at all, no fingers being cut at all. And I love that Mega Constructs. Thank you very much, Mega Constructs. Give your clap at the round with a round of applause of crap. Clap. And now, all of this has become this right here. Now this review is brought to you by viewers like you, because if it weren't people like you who watch this review, this video would have not happened. Let us first start talking about this Cyclops with the flamethrower. Yes, I know. Where's the Cyclops? Where's the one eye? It's not there, it's just a name. This one is modeled from the Halo Wars, from Halo Wars 2. Yes, I did my own research. Alright, enough of that, let's zoom into the flamethrower. Yeah. Now that flamethrower right there, mwah, I love the aesthetics. Now the flamethrower actual fire piece looks a bit more yellow rather than it does orange. On camera it's a little bit more yellow, however in person it's a little bit more orange. Another super cool thing, you can just adjust these things if you wish. That to me is just super duper cool. Boom, just like that, just that simple. So you can see much more better detail how the fire piece on the flamethrower looks like, and of course, the flamethrower doesn't always have to be shooting fire. You can take that off. And yeah, this is like the Call of Duty style flamethrower piece. It's a very excellent piece. I like it. And you get two of them in this set, which just increases its value. Now, moving on over here, you can see the other side of it. If I rotate the flamethrower, that's what you get on the other side. And believe it or not, yes, you can take off the flamethrower, but it is a little bit more work. It's not mentioned in the instructions that it's very easy to take apart. However, but that doesn't stop me from taking it apart. Yes, it may be a little bit hard, but there you go. You can take it apart. And boom, this is what you get. You get the flamethrower piece that you can use for your actual figures. Yes, that's right. Believe it or not, this little faggy piece can actually be used by the figure to simulate a very epic firing pose, right? The flamethrower can be heavy, so you just have a base plate, figure's always gonna be falling apart. However, if you attach them on something like this, boom, the figure holds and stands with no problems at all. Excellent. And then you just attach your little flamethrower piece. So yeah, and then you can take your little flyer. Ah, they get burned alive. Yeah, you know what, of course you can, it just, I really like this whole feature where you can just take a flamethrower right here and you can just use it. And the figure looks pretty good using it. To me, I just like all of that playability they incorporate. Even though it was not specifically designed to do that. And just like with the other one, you can also take it apart. But it is a bit difficult, and sometimes the pegs don't come off right. Like that, for example. You see how you still have a peg stuck in there? There we go, got it out. Which can be a little bit problematic, but it's not that big of a deal. Okay, let's go ahead and put the flamethrowers aside. What do you get right here? You get the Cyclops, which also has the fingers that you can move. Yes, three fingers. Oh, wow. Look at that flash. Look at that shine you get on the metal. I like it. Okay, anyway. Enough of the flash. Here's what the fingers look like. Boom, you can see right here, you can move each individual finger very nicely. However, you can't get a fist position. Well, you kind of can if you want to do like a punching simulation. Like, you know, you want to punch the flat. It works like this. I mean, that to me looks like an okay piece, but usually it's a bit more clenched up. You can still do that, which can look okay as a piece, but you know, if you want to have the thumb in, that's as low as it can go. If you keep pushing it, this will happen. This pops off, so. Yeah, you don't want to do that. And the same thing goes for the other arm. And yeah, you see, this arm right here, you can articulate it like this, move it around, it gives you a lot of mobility. Let's go ahead and test out how the figure can actually sit in here and pop in here, yes. Okay, Mrs. Kinsano, hop aboard. And yes, check this out, it's pretty cool actually. You just knock this thing down, boom, like that. And you see, they even incorporate technically a little grippable part right there. The figure can grip onto that part. Only, I mean, mainly on the bottom part, just here. The other parts are kind of pushed in a little bit too much, but you can still kind of simulate a little climbing position right there if you attach it up. So yeah, figure climbs up, okay. Open this door, not like that. Yeah, unfortunately, that's a problem I keep encountering when I keep trying to play with this set is these parts right here, since they're only attached on one stud, they're pretty loose. Ah, look at that, instantly. I don't know how else they could have fixed it. Maybe attach another stud over there, but I don't think it would have turned out the right way. I don't know what else could have came up. But anyways, moving this apart right here, you can see how the figure can sit right up there. Okay, excellent. Like I said before, you can get the figure to sit in, and you see this little peg right there? That's designed so you can attach the figure right here. Boom. Come on, Morgan Kinsano. Oi, forgot to lift those up right there. Aha, you attach this on, boom. Figure is attached. You go ahead and adjust the legs, give it some arm room in there, boom. Figure is adjusted, pretty well. Now what do? You close this up, shwink, shwink, boom, right there. Figure is closed up in there, then you just attach this little part right there, boom. And I mean, technically that little part can attach to those little studs right there, you see, boom, 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 but it just kind of sits there. It works better like that. If you try to attach it, you technically can, but it's not needed. You see, Morgan Kinsano right here, just lower that down, and boom! Morgan Kinsano is ready for action. Ready to flamethrower all the flag. Anyways, forgot to mention right here, this arm right here has a nice fire print right there. Yes, with the skeleton, of course, yes, be careful, beware, you know, fight. This arm does not have it, so it's only a one arm kind of thing. Moving on to the back right here. Moving on to the back, you get these flamethrower barrels, canisters, flamethrower ammunition storage devices. There you go. But yeah, you get that right there. These little things, they can bend. They can also detach pretty easily. So yeah. So yeah, you can see, these barrels, they can technically rotate. And you know why that can happen? Yeah, they can even rotate all the way upside down if you want. But yeah, because they're attached on a wheel piece like that. And I think that's a pretty genius design. You basically attach it like that. Boom, and it holds its place. And then over here, I'm not exactly sure what all of this is for. Maybe it's just to throw in there, or maybe it's because those exact pieces are actually used for the second build that you get. Yes, a second build, but you have to buy another set for it. So yeah, if you buy this set and this set, you can build something like this using their Mega Constructs here. So yeah, it's pretty tough. You get another build if you bought this set. Unfortunately, I didn't buy this set, so I can't show that off, and so I'm not reviewing this set. Yeah, but whatever. And you can basically see right here, this little section right here, boink, attaches like that, boom. Put that in there, boom. Unfortunately, the feet, yeah, they just stay stuck bent like that. And I think that is actually for the better. Because if it wasn't stuck bent like that, well, you basically wouldn't have a good stability. The figure will keep flopping and falling and other stuff, and yeah. You can see right here, it's because of this piece right here. And yeah, it's another cool thing Mega Constructs does. Super simple. Now, just because the legs are basically permanently stuck bent, that doesn't mean they're not playable. They are absolutely playable. Of course, you can rotate the legs like that, tuk-tuk-tuk-tuk-tuk, make them dance around everywhere. Yeah, but the feet right here, with the little toes, check this. Not that, don't check out that. You can see right here that the leg is on a ball joint. So if you wanted Mrs. Kinsano to do a ballerina style tick 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 and break off a toe or something, there you go, you can do it with her cyclops. The back part of the foot, this little part, oh man, it creates so much stability. And of course you can articulate. If it were for that little back part and the front, it wouldn't be as stable. So I'm very glad Mega Constructs was made. Has managed to incorporate that, otherwise it wouldn't be so stable, and plus it looks aesthetically much better. Yeah, and the other side of the feet, of course, they look like that. Ting, 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 ting. Oh yeah, and if you wanted to do, you can also do this. Make the Cyclops do the splits. Yeah, cheerleader style. Or do that. Basically, it adds a lot of playability. Hello, Morgan Quinsano. Yes, that's right. This right here is Morgan Quinsano, and Mega Constructs have done such an excellent job with this figure. Mwah! Kudos to you, Mega Constructs. Very excellent job. I'm gonna judge it as a Halo figure and not a Call of Duty figure, because this is a Halo set. So yeah, of course they know the Halo figure's not always the best, but I'll save that rant for another video. Basically, check this out, Mega Constructs have done. Look. This whole part was supposed to be that light gray, but no. They decided to place that little part a dark gray to match up more closer to her video game counterpart. It was done super duper well. I love a Mega Construct that attention to detail. Then over here, on the shoulder pads, a very nice color, you also get those little prints right there. Mwah! Beautiful. Except I think they were actually attached the other way around. There we go, now Morgan Quinsano looks the right way with those pads being flipped the other way. Excellent. And you can also see excellent paint job right there, excellent paint job on the vest, and it looks also accurate to the game, which is super duper cool. But however, look at that! They do what knockoffs do, the annoying boot trick. However, for Halo, I think it works. Though technically they could have painted the bottom part right there, but... I think it's more of a nitpick at this point, so I'm not gonna take off points for it, but yeah. Anyways, right here is what the head mold looks like. For the head mold of Mrs. Quinsano, we can see that she has the whole eyes right there, but also a paint application to go along and to complement the whole eyes, which is so much better than just having whole eyes, which gets so annoying. So yes, thank you Mega Constructs for at least giving us the white application Mrs. Quinsano deserves. Thank you. And as for the whole knives, I'm not going to take off points for that, because that's a Halo thing. Halo has always been doing it, versus Call of Duty, which never had whole knives, started doing it. That's why I take off points for Call of Duty and not this. Anyways, for the rest of the head mold, I think the head mold is done pretty well. You can see other details right here. Boom, looks pretty accurate. They also did a nice print right there. Boom, 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 boom. And of course, last but not least, what I want to show you off about this figure right here is what's underneath the vest. Because yes, Mega Constructs has actually made this a female vest plate. No, female chest plate. There we go. Female, not female. What the hell is a female? I don't know. But yeah, female. There we go. Yeah, finally I said it right. Female. Check that out. Mwah. Excellent Mega Constructs. I like the aesthetic. And unfortunately, with this vest, of course the way it's designed to fit the female chest plate, female chest mold, it can be a little bit too tight! My gosh, chico, come on! Come on! There we go, final test, yeah. So now, check this out, the super cool thing that you can do with a flat, right? You have the flat. No, Flatty, be nice, be careful, I don't want to be infected, I am Mrs. Morgan. Boom! Okay, so basically what I was trying to show you is the flat right here, you can actually attach. Now you see, this type of flat is designed for a little peg to go in, right? But Morgan Quinsano is not afraid of that. Boom! Check that out. Now Morgan Quinsano can become a flat! Yeah, that's right. Flat Morgan Quinsano. Let me go ahead and give a Morgan Quinsano a little shotgun, Halo style. Oh no, Morgan Quinsano. Now you have some bigger problems to deal with. Ay ay ay. And another super cool thing that you can do with the flat is you can switch off the positions. Check this out. You attach this right here and boom. Yeah. Now you get this weird alienated birthing. Ooh, spooky, I know. Or if you want to attach it on the back end, check out what you can do. Whoa, look at that. Just paint this little part right here for an eye, this little part right here for an eye. Just paint those two parts, and man, now you got like a cool bird monster. Or something like a squid, you know, squid head. Just in case the flood wasn't scary enough already. And yes, if you take another flat, you rip off new Morgan Quinsano's hand, arm and everything with a shotgun, you stick this in right here, boink, and now she can be fully flat. Yeah, what happens when you rip off the hand. And you also get 3 flat to make it more fun. And another thing I completely forgot about Morgan Kisano. She actually gets a helmet. Boom. Check that out. Now she has a legit way of defending herself against the flat. Yeah, good luck, flat, trying to get through a mess. Yeah, they'll find a way, but it's gonna take them a while. This is super duper cool. Basically adds so much more playability to the figure. Good job, Mega Constructs. You get this little figure stand for your Morgan Kisano to be right here. Wow, Morgan Kisano. And then we also have right here this Mega Constructs clipper. Yeah, so you can clip things. Like, for example, this instruction. If you want to clip the instruction, you just clip it right there to, let's say we want to clip it on page 64. Clink, 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 clip like that, boom. Now it's always gonna be at page 26. No, page 9, actually. Page 9, it says right there. But there you go. And then, if you want to, you can build on top of it. This is basically designed for, to do all sorts of fun things on it. Yes, yes. Boom. Morgan Kisano is on the book now. Come on, Morgan Kisano, come back to the instruction. There we go. Oh, yeah. And another super cool thing I forgot to mention. Morgan Kisano can actually grip her helmet. You attach it like that and boom, Morgan Kisano can actually grip it. Okay, everybody, it is Final Judgment. Embrace yourselves, cause this one's gonna be a big one. For the aesthetics, I give this set a 10 out of 10. The figure is well painted, well molded, the Cyclops is well painted, the flamethrowers, I love the shark print right there, the flamethrowers themselves look super good. The Cyclops, like I said, the build, the way the pieces went, aesthetically, not perfection. Even the flat, they look really good too. The only thing the flat could have used right here is maybe they could have just made this red piece the same color as the flat and just painted these little red tips if you want to be more accurate. However, that's not necessary because the flat still look really good over here, even without that thing. And not to mention, I love the green color they keep doing for Halo. Mwah! Love it. For the playability, I give this set a 9 out of 10. The flat can attach to make a flat casino. That's right, Kisano, there we go. Another problem, like I said, those pieces right here can sometimes be a little loose. However, the figure still stands, figure adjusts very comfortably in there. Figure fits very comfortably, which is exactly what you want. Plus, the whole Cyclops can stand on its own. And also, the extra helmet to attach. Mwah! Thank you, Mega Construct. For the value, I give this set an 8 out of 10. The flood, you get the flood, and you get 3 infection forms. How often does Mega Construct make flood set for Halo? Not very often. And I think they really should make more flood sets. I don't know about you, but they definitely should. And it's excellent that you get 3 flood infection forms. So, good job on them. Plus, not to mention, a named female character, Morgan Kisano. The one I keep mispronouncing every which way and where I go. Yes, and then you get flamethrower pieces. Like as if that wasn't enough, flamethrower pieces. 1, 2, which are so valuable. Not to mention the whole flamethrower, which is an excellent build. A Mega Constructs clipper, which is just thrown in, because you know, why not? I figured the only thing they could have added here, I mean, it's good enough value as is right here. The only thing I wish they could have added in, maybe instead of this clipper, maybe they could have gave you like, maybe a few sandbaggies, maybe a little terrain with sandbaggies or something like that, or maybe just a care package or something. I would have loved to at least have like a little ground something. I mean, I love the figure stand that they did here, where it's more of like a terrain base. That's also pretty excellent, but I would have also loved to expand on it, maybe made the terrain a bit better. But the terrain is not necessary, care package is only maybe to attach the helmet, but thankfully the figure can grip the helmet, so it's not that big of a problem. It's just where do you put on the flat? You just lay down around on the floor. And last but not least, for the build, I give the build a 10 out of 10. It is just incredible what Mega Constructs is able to do with all of these pieces, all of these designs. Incorporate so much playability, incorporate so much aesthetic, all expressed by the build. And the build is top, and I like it a lot. It's super duper cool. Of course, the build does have some limitations, like this part right here keeping falling off, but I don't know how else they could have made it better, so that's why I'm not taking points off of that. And like I said, for the build at first I was very bummed out. No, the legs do not bend. But that's okay, better stability, which I really, really like. And that I incorporate into the build. Because that to me is more important than having the knees bend. Also, I completely forgot to mention about the instruction right here. Check out this little cool thing they did about the build, right? This is for the flamethrower piece. So yeah, basically, they could have simply attached it like this. See that part? Point, point. But no, they decided to add a little peg to stabilize it. That right there is what I'm talking about, Mega Constructs. Very, very excellent job. I love it, Mega Constructs, when you do that. And that brings us to our final score, which I give a 9.25 out of 10. It's an A, and a well-deserved A. Hey, why did Kisano fall down? Here we go. Well, my comrades, I hope you enjoyed this review. If you did, be sure to give it a nice big like. And as always, comrades, if you want to see more content from me, a friendly porcupine, you know what to do. Hit subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next re-video. Re-video. Hit subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video, my comrades. Take care, everybody. Boom. KO, knocked out. Oh yeah, and I forgot to mention, look how much I wrote for this review. Yeah, I put in a lot of work into my reviews. Boom. Check out all of these others, like basically this whole book filled up with reviews that I kept doing. Boom. 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 This is all of my information and all of the reviews that I did. It's a lot and a lot. So if you guys like the effort, if you guys enjoyed the effort, be sure to give it a nice big fat juicy like. And as always, my comrades, if you want to see more content from me and Friendly Porcupine, you know what to do. Hit subscribe and I'll catch you in the next video. Isn't that right, Mr. Flood? Boom. Yeah, take that, Flood. You don't stand a chance against a Friendly Porcupine. Ay, chico.